morning students. I am K. Lokesh, working as a lecturer in Satyam College of Education. Okay. Today we will discuss about a topic on environmental education. Okay. Actually, in the last class we have started the fourth paper of environmental education in fourth semester with Swachh Bharat. Okay. The Swachh Bharat campaign execution and different activities in Swachh Bharat, all those things we have discussed in earlier classes. Okay. Now today we will start the second chapter, which is meaning, importance, objectives and aims of environmental education. Okay. And also the main components of environmental education, environmental degradation, okay, and different other topics also is there in the second chapter. Okay. So today in this class we will discuss about the meaning and objectives of environmental education. Okay. Actually, we know about the meaning of environment. So the term environment or environ means our surroundings. Okay. So what are the main components which are involved in this environment means biotic factors and abiotic factors, which means living things and non-living things. If you see, living things are main flora and fauna, different types of animals and plants, and microbes, bacteria, virus, and little invertebrates or little small lives on this earth. Okay, these are all called biotic factors or living things. In the same way, non-living things also is there in environment, which are rocks, mountains, hills, deserts, lakes, oceans, okay, and other water bodies and different types of soils. All these are called as non-biotic factors or non-living forms. Okay. We surrounded by all these living and non-living things. Okay. So to understand the meaning of environment, we have to know about the clear-cut knowledge about the main factors which are involving in this environment. Okay. So environmental education allows the individual to explore different issues and different challenges regarding the environment. Okay. So in this paper fourth, we will understand what are the main issues and the challenges and protection measures and different types of acts to conserve the environment, and what is mean by the environmental degradation, forestation, deforestation and reforestation. Okay. And environmental protection acts and the conservation of the environment, all these things we will study in this paper. Okay. Let us know the main components of environmental education. Okay. So when we see in depth of the environmental education paper, we come to and understand about the different components are there in environmental education, which are components of environmental education: awareness and sensitivity to environment and environmental challenges. Okay. And knowledge and understanding of the environment and environmental challenges. Okay. In the same way, attitudes of concern for the environment and motivation to improve or maintain the environmental quality. Okay. And next, skills to identify and help to resolve environmental challenges. Okay. And participation in activities that lead to resolution of environmental challenges. Okay. These are the main components of environmental components. Okay. And next, we have to know the main ethics of environmental education, how this topic is introduced in educational institutions in a different levels. For example, environmental education is there in the primary schools or primary sector, secondary schools, and next higher secondary schools, colleges, and university courses and other scientific and technology courses is also there, the environmental education. Okay, the main implementation of this subject is to understand the environment and to protect the environment, and as a human how to live in this environment, and how to protect the environmental laws, and how to live in this world with other species and other biotic and abiotic factors as a justice and human needs. Okay, in this sense we have to understand the main environmental education attitudes and values and main traditions and ethics results in this chapter. Okay, for example, if you see, there are different kinds of objectives are there and aims are there for studying about the environmental education. Okay, for example, if we see the main aims of environmental education, okay, the main of environmental education is given by the UNESCO, okay, the United Nations of organization, sub organization which is UNESCO. This is given by a beautiful aim. Okay, the main aim of environmental education is to clearly to show the economic, social, political and ecological interdependence of the modern world. Okay, all these things which is economical, political and social and also the ecological. Ecological means all surroundings or all biosystems are there involving in this manner. Okay, so all these things will be interdependent on one and another in this modern world. Okay, in which decisions and actions by different countries can have international repercussions. Okay, not only one country should not be spoil the environment, all countries should be cooperated and correlated with one and another in this environmental issues. Okay, in the same way, the main aim of environmental education at root level is to succeed in making individuals and communities understand the complex nature of the natural environment and to build the environment. So finally, mainly in human, when the human study these environmental education chapters, definitely he has to know some kinds of values and knowledge skills he has to develop, and finally he has to make a strong attitude to protect the environment and to conserve the resources and different types of environmental issues also. Okay, so when you see the natural world, so there is only one earth in this solar system, there is no another earth to live and go there. That's why nowadays the population is growing. Okay, in 1800 AD there is only 100 crores of people are there in this world. Okay, the main population is 100 crores. So now in this 21st century nearly the population is increased up to 750 crores. Okay, but the landmarks are not increased. Okay, or the areas of the land is not increasing that much level. That's why we have to adjust to live in this world as a brotherhood thing, and cooperatively and friendly in manner we have to live with another components also. Okay, and the main objectives of environmental education, when we see, we have some kinds of awareness to protect the environment. Okay, and we have a strong knowledge to conserve the environment, and attitudes building for motivating to protect the environment. Okay, and evaluation of environmental measurements. Okay, we have to evaluate that we are protecting or not the environment, what are our concern activities which are making the clear cut environment or disturbing the environment. Okay, we have to identify. In the same way,
the main objectives of environmental education is to build up some kinds of participation skills and interdiction skills of the human being. Okay, these are the main objectives of environmental education. And finally, there is some principles are there to know the environmental perspectives. Okay, these are called as guiding principles. Okay, guiding principles of the environmental education. Okay, guiding principles of environmental education. So in this guiding principles, mainly there are five kinds of principles are there. Okay, number one is the resource principles. Okay, in this resource principles, there are two kinds of resources are there. Okay, renewable resources and non renewable resources are there. Okay, for example, renewable resources means water, air, environment, like that. And non-renewable resources means fossil fuels, okay, and fresh water, all these things. In the same way, the second guiding principles is soil principles. Soil principles means there are different soils are there. For example, grasslands and deserts, oceanic areas, mountains, okay, and next seashores, like that. Okay, how to protect these soils and what are the activities we should not make in this soil areas, we have to know. This is the soil principles. And wildlife protection principles. So wildlife means the flora, different kinds of flora and fauna which are living in the forest areas or in our domestic life, all these are called as a wildlife. Generally, domestic animals are not called as wildlife, but the animals and the plants which are living in rare areas, particularly in forest, are called as wildlife. So we have to protect these wildlife, flora and fauna, because when we disturb this flora and fauna with our human activities, the ecological balance will be depleted and destroy the niche, ecological niche and ecological balance in the environment, which cause the next future generations of the human being. Okay, and we have established different types of activity acts and wildlife conservation acts are there in our government of India. Okay, by the action of parliament, and parliament accepted. Okay, by this different acts we are conserving and protecting wildlife also. Okay, and next the fourth one guiding principle is environmental management principles. Environmental management means, environmental management principle is mainly how to recycle the waste materials in the environment. Okay, and waste water management, like that. Okay, and the fifth principle is other principle. In this other principle, there is a cultural, historical, archaeological and traditional environmental components will be comes. For example, in our India, there are so many traditional, historical and archaeological monuments are there. Okay, we have to protect them, and we have to resolve the problems which are surrounded by this traditional and historical monuments. Okay, for example, in our India, Tanjavur temple is there and Taj Mahal is there. Okay, these are the ancient great monuments. Okay, they are living on this earth since nearly 1000 years. Okay, but the human action is depleting their gloriousness and beautiness. Okay, for example, the Taj Mahal stone is having the erosion by the effect of chemical and red chemical and air pollution in Agra. In the same way, there are different Indian temples and historical king palaces also is there. They are having erosions of wind speeds and earthquakes like that. Okay, so in environmental conservation, two kinds.